Good morning, sir. Good morning, my students. Hope everyone is doing well. Student, as you are aware that today our honorary guest, Mr. Shailendra Mukherjee, the senior area general manager, Lords Plaza, Ankleshwar, will share his views and help us to expand our knowledge on how and ways to promote tourism in India. So, Mukherjee sir, you can proceed now, sir.
Thank you, sir, for inviting me. Good morning, friends. I hope everybody is doing well. Stay safe. I am sure these are difficult times for the tourism industry, the travel trade industry, and the hospitality industry. But there is always a silver lining at the end of the day. Probably from 8th of June, we are opening up in many places, if not all, as per the latest directives that have come from MHA. So, looking for a better tomorrow very soon. Coming back to my topic today, I was requested to give you some inputs on travel and tourism. So, I thought this is the best time to share my views on how we can improve the tourism sector in India. So, coming back to the point. Present situation of the tourism sector in India. First, we'll go point by point. We will see ways to improve the tourism also. So, in case you, I will speak for some time, and in case you people have any questions, please go ahead with it. You can stop me in between, let's say, after I finish the first half. Is that clear, everybody?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. I don't know how many of you all know that India was ranked one of the top 10 best countries to visit in the world. It was ranked along with Scotland, Canada, and etc. With places like Taj Mahal, City Palace in Jaipur, Qutub Minar, Gateway of India, and some of the popular tourist places in India. So India is a very rich subcontinent with its vibrant culture and incredible heritage. The heritage of India goes many, many years back. So, we have a lot of tourist places, believe you me, and many of the places are yet to be explored. And honestly speaking, I am basically from Bengal. I have been to North Bengal. There are such of lovely areas which are yet to be explored by the tourism sector. And there is so much of ample opportunity for us to explore and improve our tourism. So, saying that, we can also say that, guess how much of, what is the annual income from the tourism sector approximately? It is around 15 to 20 lakh crores annually, what we get from the tourism sector. So, you see, there's a lot of potential, but unfortunately for us, we Indians, we are yet to develop it the way other countries have done it. You, in the ways of infrastructure, in the ways of safety and security, there are different ways we will go one by one during my course. So, though India is one of the greatest potentials in the tourism sector, you see China, on the other hand, with its advanced ways of metros, clean roads, airports, and developed technology, it's way ahead in terms of its culture and heritage. China is, why we are comparing with China? Because China also has lots of old heritage attached to it. That's the reason. But India has, we have got so much of pollution and lack of infrastructure, which if we can take care of, I think we will be able to improve the tourism sector a lot. So now, till now, anybody has any questions in it? No. Okay.
No, sir.
Great. If I'm getting too boring, please let me know. I will change my course. Okay. Now, guys, let me ask you, how many of you all can tell me the ways that we can promote our tourism in India? Okay, anybody can come in. Huh? I'm okay with it.
So I would like to give a suggestion.
Yeah, please.
We can improve our social platforms so that we can attract the customers. Like, for an example, if we promote the ways through which we promote our hygiene, quality, and food wellness through our websites or official websites, we can attract the customers. So, this is the way to promote tourism, I guess.
Excellent. That is what you're telling is doing marketing strategies for image formation, right?
Yes,
through social media and everything. So that is one of the ways I, that's a great, this thing. Anybody else? Any other points?
So I would like to say that we can nowadays, we can more promote clean India, green India. It is already Mr. Prime Minister Modi is also promoting the cleanliness regarding each and every sector as well as each and every village as well as city. So we can
Excellent.
Do more city clean as well as neat. So we should awareness all kind of people which we are surrounding living our society that if there is a dustbin that you should put any kind of trash in a particular dustbin. So we can nowadays
great.
Dubai and Dubai, Canada, Australia is very clean and neat city rather than India.
Yes, yeah, so keeping our environment friendly basically.
Exactly, sir.
Yeah. So we have got marketing strategies through social media, which is one of the main things. The Incredible India campaigns are already on through social media platforms. Then we have got a clean and green. Anybody else? I think we have got two excellent this thing. Anybody else? Some more?
Yes.
I think that सेफ्टी और क्लीननेस और ये सब तो अभी जो कोरोना का ये चल रहा है पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन से चल रहा है तो ये तो सभी रखेंगे अभी आई थिंक अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए सबको कोई थोड़ी ऑफर या ऐसा कुछ रखना चाहिए
ओके ओके
सिचुएशन में तो सभी क्लीननेस और फूड और वेलनेस और वो सब पे सभी लोग एक साथ कंसंट्रेशन करेंगे वो तो अलग चीज नहीं होगी दूसरों से पर अगर इस टाइम पे ऑफर बहुत कम देंगे कोई भी तो हम अगर
ओके व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग इज फ्रॉम द होटल पर्सपेक्टिव राइट ये होटल्स क्या ऑफर दे रहे हैं एम आई राइट
यस सर
ओके मैं जो बात कर रहा हूँ हाउ टू इम्प्रूव द टूरिज्म ऑल ओवर इन अ होलिस्टिक मैनर ओके So let's the first two points were excellent. Yeah, please.
To interrupt, but I'm also talking about resorts and other hotels like everywhere.
Correct.
Five-star hotels and everywhere. They can make some packages like 1,000 may 2 days, 3 nights, aisa kuch.
Excellent. Making attractive packages.
Yes.
Okay, great. Yeah. Anything else? Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
I think, sir, we should to need जो हमारा partner है जो हमें guest को
I think sorry, I'm. Hello. There is a lot of disturbance from somebody's background. If rest everybody can mute your calls and only one person who's speaking can unmute it and go ahead.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, I think जो हमारा business partner है like जो हमें guest को देते हैं उनके साथ भी उतना ही share करना चाहिए कि हम जो भी facility दे रहे हैं इधर अभी जैसे corona virus के बाद हम जो HACCP के ऊपर काम करने वाले हैं जिस तरह से हम डिस्टेंस रखने वाले वो सब उनको भी गाइड करना चाहिए उतना ही और वो भी गेस्ट को उसी तरह से गाइड करें इसके लिए भी हमें उनको मतलब कुछ ज्यादा ही एक्स्ट्रा भले उनके लिए जो भी पे करना वो करके उनको कुछ एक्स्ट्रा मतलब गेस्ट को समझाने के लिए मतलब
सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी फ्रॉम हाइजीन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से राइट
यस
ओके दैट्स गुड द सेफ्टी मेजर्स इन द होटल्स यस
So I would like to instill one more point. We can insist the government, mainly the Ministry of Tourism, for implementing certain incentives, like constituting a task force for improving the hospitality and tourism industry?
Yes, we can. The Federation of Hotel and Restaurant Association of India should take up this initiative. Yes.
और सर ऑल्सो हमें जो किचन का पूरा लाइव रेस्टोरेंट में मतलब लाइव टीवी पे दिखाना चाहिए, लाइव एलसीडी पे दिखाना चाहिए कि हमारा किचन में किस तरह से काम हो रहा
है. The cleanliness and the hygiene factors that are taken care in the kitchen, right?
Yes.
Okay. Good. Very valid points I'm getting. Excellent. I'm increasing my knowledge also. So okay, there are a couple of more points. I would like to go ahead now. How we can promote tourism in India post COVID, pre COVID, whatever you say. So first of all, what I think we should try to create traveling experience for tourists rather than just attractions. Abhi ke tourist attraction hai. We should create an experience out of that attraction. Like traveling is an experience rather than just visiting the tourist attraction. So in order to promote the tourism of India, I think we need to invest some time and effort in building the traveling experience for the people with tour guides, activities for children, culinary tours. Then we can have interactive interactivity of the tourists with the culture of the place. So basically, we should have ideas such as India shoestring, India in luxury, Royal India, Urban India, things like that. It's like a marketing strategy, and we should have a travel experience rather than a travel attraction. Hum agar ek jagah pe jaye, like I'll tell you in Rajasthan what happens. When you go to Rajasthan, they take you to sand dunes. I don't know how many of you all have visited Jaisalmer. Anybody has visited Jaisalmer? Good.
Yes, sir.
You have been to Samdani? Okay, no, Samdani are the sand dunes. So the attraction is the sand dunes and you see the sunset. But what is the experience? The experience is it is around 15 kilometers from the main city, the sand dunes, the desert, actual desert. So they take you by jeep or whatever vehicle, and at a certain point they drop you, and from there you are made to ride a camel. So the experience starts from there. You are made to ride a camel. And with the camel ride, you start going on the sand dunes for another 2 to 3 kilometers. Okay. And then you see the sunset from there. And then they take you to a tent, and where they have this local folk dances and local food given to you. And you can opt to stay in the tent overnight. And next day breakfast. And then they take you back, bring you back to the main city. So it is a total experience overall. The attraction is only the sand dune and the sunset, but only to go there and see the sunset is no experience. They give you a whole experience of it. So we should have more such experiences happening rather than only going to, let's say, we just go to Qutub Minar and come back. No, we should go to Qutub Minar. We should have a experience of understanding what was Qutub Minar built for, or what was Taj Mahal built for, with the local tourist guides and everything. So it is an experience of itself. Am I getting to the point between attraction, yes, and experience?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you know, when you go to desert, they show you local dance, the folk dances. Then they have these, which is called Kalvelia, and then they show this puppet dance of Rajasthani puppet shows. Okay. So it is a wholesome experience where the locals also earn, the camel owners earn, then they sell local artifacts and everything there. For the foreigners, it is like heaven there. Okay. So it is a wholesome experience. Same thing in Dubai. When you go to Dubai, they take you in these Fortuners and big SUVs in the deserts and give you those rides in the desert. So that's an experience. So coming to the next point, we should have more hygiene and amenities for kids and disabled. Today, today if I go with my family, I would like to see, I see India is like a very close-knit family culture. So we would like to have our kids and our old age parents coming along with us to places. So how do we, so we need to have these facilities. So we have to be absolutely sure that we have reserved parking for handicapped people or reserved parking for old people. Then we should have facilities for handicapped chair facilities, the wheelchairs. So when it comes to traveling within the cities of India, public transport also need to be highlighted and informed so well that the travelers should not have any problem in exploring. And we should have children-friendly destinations. We very, very few of our destinations, we can say, are children-friendly. So we need to come up with more such experience places. So that is one place. Third, I think we should have some historical monuments. We should be preserving our historical monuments. Like any other nation in the world can hardly match up with the number of historical monuments that the Department of Tourism and the landscape of India. But they can't match up with the kind of creativity and inscriptions that go into ruining those monuments. You see, these historical monuments, they local people or tourists, when we go, a lot of people have this habit of inscripting their names and all rubbish on the walls. We should try to avoid these things. And we should ensure that other people also do not do it. Okay, for anybody who does it, there should be a punishment for it. I'm sure everybody has noticed it, right? When you go to some good place, nice place, there are, people have, you know, they try to scratch off things and those things should be avoided. So another is the marketing strategy, what has been already shared with one of our friends here. India is like Atithi Deva Bhava. I'm sure everybody has heard this phrase, right?
Yes, sir.
We should be friendly to tourists. You know, we have, in many of our places, there is a tendency, अरे tourist है तो इसको cheating करो, इससे ज़्यादा ले लो, whether it's a auto rickshaw driver or it's a tourist guide or anybody. So we should avoid those things as a country to attract more tourists. That they should feel that नहीं, we are not being cheated. So and we should be always there with a friendly smile and a friendly reception. Then we have to promote our festivals to enhance Indian traditions. We have an N number of festivals in India. So like, you know, we do Christmas also, we do Rath Yatra also, we do Janmashtami also, we do Eid also. So we do a lot of N number of festivals in this country. So we need to promote these festivals, and we have Holi also. So these festivals should be encashed on to promote tourism. Like if you go to Spain, I'm sure there's a, I've forgotten the name of the movie, Tomatino Festival is there. It's was shown, festival. I think. You remember the Tomatino Festival?
Yes,
there was a movie on this, Rakesh Roshan was there. I've forgotten the name of the movie. I'm bad at
Ritik Roshan, huh?
Yes, Ritik Roshan, sorry, not Rakesh Roshan, Ritik Roshan. Correct. So they are encouraging, they are encashing on their festival. So we should try to encash on our festivals also and promote those festivals. So that is one of them where we can improve our tourism. Then we should have adventure-friendly infrastructure. Our infrastructure should be adventure-friendly. India has yet to cover miles when it comes to offering secure adventure facilities for travelers. So you see, with more and more people co-scaping adventure and tourism, this infrastructure is very essential. That, and we need to upgrade from its present, you know, poor state. It's in a very poor state. I've got friends who do these mountaineerings, and I've learned from them that we don't have enough infrastructure for them today. So we need to improve this infrastructure, because we have got these mountains, the Himalayas and all, where there are a lot of, you can promote tourism, this adventure tourism. So we need to do this. Then there are lots of places, as I was telling at the beginning of my session, there are lots of unseen places, unexplored places in the country. I'm sure a lot of you must have gone to a lot of places where you see very few people have actually gone. There are I have seen in North Bengal a lot of places. I have seen in Himachal there are a lot of places where where it is unexplored. And even if we try to do, there is no infrastructure to go to those places, proper infrastructure as far as tourists are concerned. The roads are, we need to have more good roads. The good roads are not there. If somebody goes there, good hotels are not there. And the overall infrastructure is not developed. And India has so much to give. But we are yet to develop our infrastructure. And we need to revisit the unseen and the unexplored. That is very, very important. Then we need to understand how tourism can change the face of the nation. This should have been the first point. The day we understand how tourism can change the face of our nation, half the battle is won. It can definitely bring us more value, income, and an image to our nation and bring us in the top contenders on the list of travel destinations.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, as we know that Lord's Plaza Ankleshwar is one of the finest business hotels in Ankleshwar. So, sir, what will be your plans to promote tourism? As we know that domestic tourism will have an upper hand as compared to the international tourism. So, what will be your ideas or your incentives to attract the customers or the tourists?
If you tell me for Lord's Plaza Ankleshwar specifically, Ankleshwar is a 100% corporate destination. Okay, a lot of people have a false thing that it is a tourist place or Ankleshwar being anything to do with Lord Shiva, right? You're thinking of that way? No. Ankleshwar is a 100% industrial zone. It has nothing to do with tourists. I am in this hotel as a general manager and the unit head for last 10 years. Okay. And this is one of the biggest industrial GIDCs of Asia with more than 2,500 small and big units, mainly pharmaceutical units in the place. Okay? There's nothing to do with tourism. Ankleshwar word comes from a family of Ankleshwarias. This place was mainly owned, the lands were owned by a family called Ankleshwarias. They are still there. Parsis, they are Parsis. So from there, this word Ankleshwar comes, and it has nothing to do with Lord Shiva or any tourist destination. So I hope I've made my point clear.
Yeah, definitely, sir.
Yeah. So this is a industrial hub and nothing to do with tourists. So for tourists, this place is zero. My occupancy on an average year round is around 76-77%. Okay. And it is 100% only on corporates and not with tourists. But to top it up, yes, for last 1 year, we are getting little bit of tourist inflow from Sardar Fort, the Statue of Unity, from the time the Statue of Unity has come in. Okay. So people from Bombay who are traveling have a halt in this hotel. For them, we have made in packages where they can come. They can stay overnight. They can have. They can take our vehicle also. We'll give them packed lunch, and they can come back in the evening, have dinner, and next day check out. So we have made those packages for people who are traveling to Statue of Unity, specifically from the Bombay side, from the western side of the country. Okay.
Okay. Yes.
This is only for Statue of Unity because the drive from Ankleshwar is around 1 hour from for the Statue of Unity. So basically, Statue of Unity has two approach roads, one from Ankleshwar and one from Baroda. So for the eastern side, it's Baroda. From the western side, it is Ankleshwar. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. Any other questions coming in?
No, sir.
So, okay, good. So till now, we are on with it. So yes, why do you think we should promote the tourism? Anybody? Why should we promote tourism?
Sir, in order to boost our economy.
Good. Yes. Yes. Create jobs on the local platform.
Yeah, to create employment, to boost our economy.
Reduce poverty.
To get the revenue.
Develop different sectors. Okay. So those are a couple of points I think we should do to promote tourism. Okay. Yes. Then what are the problems of tourism? Anybody?
So people are exactly not aware about the tourist spots. Like if I'm talking about Surat, many people don't know about the local aquarium which we have. So this may hamper the tourism, I guess.
What are the problems? Well, what are the hazards of tourism? Okay, let me change my sentence. What are the hazards of tourism?
Sir, damages of landscapes.
Lack of the marketing, sir. Lacking of proper marketing mm-hmm. to the proper place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody said landscapes. Yeah. What else?
Yeah, damages of sir landscapes and all those things because of and traffic congestions and pollutions to over tourism and all. Because of over tourism coming.
What's your name?
Rinkesh.
Rinkesh, okay. Good. There is a Department of Tourism, the Government of India. They have, we have got a pledge. How many of you know the pledge for safe and sustainable tourism? Has it been discussed ever with you? No?
No, sir.
Okay. You know, we, the Government of India urges all of us, we hoteliers specifically, to take a pledge once we join this industry. Okay. You can find it in the net also. I'll just read it out. That would be my closing comments. We have a pledge. I'll just read out the pledge. Wherever you do not understand, I will explain it in a simpler language once I read out the pledge. Okay. I'll go through it slowly. The pledge in the beginning says, pledge for commitment towards safe and honorable tourism and sustainable tourism. And then it says, we solemnly pledge to reiterate our commitment to conduct our business in a manner that befits the culture and ethos of our rich and ancient civilization and tolerant and accommodating nature of our multicultural society and protects all individuals, especially women and children, from all derogatory acts which are contrary to the spirit of our country. We hereby commit to abide by the code of conduct for safe and honorable tourism, recognizing that every earth source is finite and fragile. We further pledge to fully implement sustainable tourism practices consistent with the best environment and heritage protection standards, such that our present tourism resource requirements optimize both local community benefit and sustainable uses. I don't know, it's a little tough language. It's simple English, but tough language to understand. In nutshell, this says that we promise to conduct our tourism in such a way that we will respect women and children, whether they are in the form of tourists or our colleagues. Also, we will try to save our environment while conducting our business. We will save our ancient civilization. We will try to keep up to our rich ethos and cultures. And also recognizing that doing rainwater harvesting and then solar energy. So this is protecting the environment, basically. So it says that we further pledge to fully implement sustainable tourism practices like rainwater harvesting, etc., consistent with best environment and heritage protection standards are the requirements for optimize both local community benefit for future sustainable uses. So you can get this. I'm just reading this pledge out. It is Annexure 1. It is there in Department of Tourism, Safe and Honorable Tourism. You can go to the Sustainable India website and see it. So we all have to, once we generally, at least in lodge, when we induct new people, new staff, whether in any designation or post, we make them read it, make them understand it, and they have to sign it, and we keep it in their personal files. That yes, they have learned it, and the pledge is such that yes, in future we will ensure that this is taken care of. Okay. So quickly wrapping up, anything else that anybody wants to ask on this? Professor Chaudhary?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I think we are...
Can I over the session?
Sir, I have one question.
Yeah, please.
Sir, will cost much to manage? So how will you... how will profit after COVID-19?
Sorry, come again. Your voice was cracking. Your what cost?
Hotel will cost much to manage. So after COVID-19, how will you profit?
No, I still did not get your
sir,
question.
I mean, जो हमारा होटल की कॉस्ट है वो बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ने वाला है.
क्यों?
Like सैनिटाइजर और कुछ प्रमोट करने के लिए तो हम कैसे मैनेज करेंगे और बिजनेस भी कमी होने वाला है लाइक गेस्ट तो उतना जल्दी नहीं आने वाले
आपका आपका कॉस्ट वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन एक्सेलेंट क्वेश्चन आपका कॉस्ट एक होटल का मेनली कॉस्ट कहाँ पे आता है एनी आइडिया व्हाट आर द मेन कॉस्ट फैक्टर्स फ्रॉम वेयर द होटल गोज इट इज HLP एंड मैन पावर ओके HLP is heat light power, which is electricity, gas, etc. And second is manpower. So these are the main places where we incur the major cost in a hotel. Okay. So abhi aapko ye do jagah aapko dekhna padega. Aap kaise isko cost manage karoge. Abhi, jaise for example, aaj ki date pe mera hotel mein mano 80 employee hai. Okay. So we need to see abhi COVID-19 ke liye kafi log chale gaye. We need to see what मिनिमम स्टाफिंग से हम होटल को चला सकते हैं और जैसे जैसे होटल का ऑक्यूपेंसी बढ़ेगा वैसे वैसे हम स्टाफिंग ग्रेजुअली बढ़ाना पड़ेगा अगर आज की डेट पे मेरा 80 एम्प्लॉयज है और सारे 80s को मैं बुला लूं होटल में और सिर्फ 10 रूम आज मेरा भरा हुआ है सो आई विल बी रनिंग एट अ लॉस यू गेट माई पॉइंट सो दैट इज वन पॉइंट वेर यू हैव टू मैनेज योर मैन पावर सेकेंड कम्स हीट लाइट पावर We need to be very careful and very, we have to monitor each and every place where there is a consumption of heat, light and power. What are the major consumptions of heat, light and power? Is AC and our gas. So air conditioning, we need to open each floor wise. We should not open the entire hotel in one go. Jitna occupied ho, pehle ek floor ko bharo. फिर एक फ्लोर भर गया फिर ऑक्यूपेंसी अगर बढ़ रहा है देन स्टार्ट ओपनिंग द सेकंड फ्लोर देन द थर्ड फ्लोर देन द फोर्थ फ्लोर देन द फिफ्थ फ्लोर इट शुड बी फ्लोर वाइज एंड नॉट एवरी द एंटायर होटल इन वन शॉट सो दैट इज हाउ यू कैन वन वे मैनेज योर एसी कॉस्ट सेकंड इज द मेन गजलिंग पॉइंट इज योर एग्जॉस्ट किचन एग्जॉस्ट किचन एग्जॉस्ट टेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सो यू नीड टू मॉनिटर द टाइमिंग ऑफ द ऑपरेशन ऑफ द किचन एग्जॉस्ट You need to fix a timing. अच्छा मेरा peak time कितना है इतना बजे से इतना बजे तक है तो मैं उतना timing ही चलाऊंगा और वो खत्म हो जाए तो हम we should have a system in place where somebody is designated to go and switch it off. So that there is no unnecessary wastage of our electricity. Is that clear?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, sir.
So we need to be you are very right. There will be some increase in cost. For buying sanitizers and disinfectants and everything, but we need to understand how to reduce the cost in other places so that we can compensate this. Once the occupancy increases, everything goes null and void. वो सब ठीक हो जाएगा, बराबर हो जाएगा. लेकिन पहले हमें occupancy बढ़ाना पड़ेगा. Yeah, please.
Sir, are you thinking about reducing the tariffs for no. lower occupancies?
No, tariff reduction is not the answer to it. Because if you see the airlines and everybody, nobody has reduced their tariffs currently. Because there is a lot of additional cost that is getting involved in it. So I don't think reduction of tariff is the right answer.
Students, anybody asks any questions? Sir, is Hari?
No, that's okay. Please.
Sir, there is only one question.
Yeah.
Only one question, sir. सर सेम लाइक कार्निवल फेस्टिवल सेम लाइक जो ब्राजील या फिर वी आर डूइंग इन गोवा ऑल्सो तो शुड बी मोर enhance the carnivore festival to promote our festivals as well as promote our culture.
That's what I said, that we should promote our festivals and we should give it
through the carnival festival
We have one in Goa happening in the month of December. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So same, but it is not throughout India.
Okay, it's not possible for all the India.
In different parts of the state, there are different festivals specifically. Not necessarily that one carnival festival has to be done all over India. But there are different festivals for different parts of the country. So we should try to promote and encash on those also. That's what I meant.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else? Professor Saab?
Yes, sir.
I think that's it. So let's call it off. Thank you so much. Thank you, friends.
1 minute, sir. 1 minute. This is that last. Yeah. Thanks for sparing your valuable time and conducting the session of our LM students. Your views are of utter importance to us. Thank you once again, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you, friends. Thank you, Professor Saab. Thank you so much.